best way how to consolidate your KPIs is actually by using a disconnected table and DAX. So let's see how we can do this. So what you see on the screen here is we have our model and our fact tables again separated. So we have the finance, subscriptions and web. And we have some measures already predefined here, but now we want to consolidate them all. So what we'll do here, we'll create a disconnected table called cards KPI, and let's just see how it looks. So it is a simple table that has all our KPIs listed and just assigned a KPI ID here. So how we can then leverage this to present all our KPIs? We create a measure that is filtering our data for the KPIs. So what we do here is we simply click on the element of the table and go to the home page and create a new measure. So for this case, we'll start with AC as usual. So this is short for actuals, and we'll write a switch statement. So if we write in switch, our first argument of the switch statement needs to be some sort of aggregation that will tell on which KPIs we will actually be writing the values. So we'll write in the minimum aggregation for KPI. And usually what you would do here is you would use the KPI ID, as this would be best for performance purposes. But in our case, just to illustrate better, we will use the KPI. So let's close, and now we can start writing our KPIs. So depending on the KPI IDs, as we can see, the first one is revenue, but we can simply now specify the names. So what we will do here is create go into the new line and here write in revenue. So on this value, we want the cards to display the revenue. And because we have this measure already in the finance table, so if we just take a quick look here, you have our AC revenue already defined. So what we can do here is we can simply use this same measure for the revenue. And we will write it in, so AC revenue, and this is our measure now. The next KPI, we want to show the revenue just for a certain group of products. So what we will do here is we will write in the revenue for merch. All right. And now we need to filter the AC revenue just for those specific products. So we'll write in a calculate statement and write in the AC revenue followed by filter for those products. So for product equals to merch and parentheses and so on and so on. So the next one would be, we could just reuse the same if we want to create the one for the revenue for Bryce. So we can just simply copy and paste this and just replace the merch in this case with Bryce. And the same on the filter. Now let's quickly test this measure. So we just hit enter and let's go to the report page and let's place the AC into the cards here. We have them separated by the KPIs. So if we just place them into the values, we should now see all three KPIs displayed. So I will not go over all the KPIs. We have more than 20 listed here, but I will simply paste the rest of the KPIs, which we can extrapolate the same logic for the rest. So if I just go here. Okay, so now we paste in the rest of the KPIs. And you can see that we have some empty spaces here. But what we will try to illustrate here is that you can also reuse certain KPIs here. So for example, here we have a KPI that is average revenue per unit. In our example, this will be our subscriptions. So we can simply just write in our calculation for the revenue here. So we take this and we can simply use a divide or just divide it as so, and just write in the denominator and numerator. So we will write here the AC revenue per subscription. So we'll take this and place it here for the next parameter, and we could do the same then for the products. So we'll use the same here. We'll just copy and paste this, divide it, just remove the column here, and just divide it by the subscriptions for the merch. And write in the next. So you can simply just take this and replace it with Bryce. So for the gross margin now will be of course calculated by between the AC revenue and the cost. So we write in the AC revenue minus the costs. AC costs, and the same can be done then for the rest. Okay, and now we have all our KPIs populated. But then you would say, okay, but do I need to do this for all my measures? I need to list them one by one for also for my plan and forecast. And actually, if you have this structured in this way, you can simply use find and replace for all those measures. So I can copy the same measure. I can just click new measure and paste it in. And I would select the AC and space at the start now and hit Control Shift L and just write in PL space for the plan. Hit Enter. And I've also created now the plan measures. If I now do the same for the forecast, just copy and paste, select the PL space and just Control Shift L again, forecast and enter. But what you see now is that we don't have the forecast data for the subscriptions data. So what we need to do here is we simply remove those elements for the forecast. Okay, hit enter. And now we have all our measures prepared. So let's try to bring them into the Zebra BI cards. Let's minimize this. So we have our KPIs. If we place in the AC placeholder now into the values, we get all our cards displayed. We'll add in a plan measure for our targets and also our forecast. Okay, we have all our KPIs now displayed. And lastly, what we need to do is add in a month trend into the categories. And we should now have all our KPIs displayed in one consolidated way, in one visual, as is best practice. So we've shown you three different ways on how to consolidate your KPIs for Zebra BI cards. For more information, go to our web page or write to support@zebrabi.com. See you in the next release.